There's no better way to wait out the quarantine or the impending apocalypse of COVID-19 than boarding up the windows and singing along to Moon Ring. Moon Ring. It's Wade.
It's Wade.
It's Wade.
It's Wade.
Wade's World. It's Wade.
Hell yeah, boy. Are we on? All right, we're on. How you doing, everybody? Welcome to Wade's World, episode 9. Episode 9. I can't believe that we've been doing this for 9 weeks now. That's unbelievable to even say. Yeah, and we have a crazy friend, very hungover crazy friend. Where are you calling from, William Clark Green?
Fort Worth, Texas.
Fort Worth, Texas. The boonies of Fort Worth, Texas. And we have spent the last hour with my guest trying to figure out how to get him up and running, and we're there. How you doing,
computer,
William Clark Green?
Computers and me don't get along very well.
Welcome to the show, buddy.
Thanks for having me, Wade. I'm sorry I've been stressful, and my lack of technology, knowing technology, has been stressful. But
no, not at all, man. Not at all.
Friendship comes with repercussions.
Well, I knew that way before we did the Zoom meeting. And I want to say hello to everybody. If you might be new to Wade's World, we did this thing, like I said, 9 weeks ago, and we were doing having guests here at my house, and it was a blast having everybody here. But then we were trying to follow all the guidelines, you know, make sure that we kept everybody safe, especially my wife and my kids. And so we stopped having people over as our guests and started doing them virtually like this. And so this is what we're, the hand that we're dealt right now, man. I'd look forward to doing this again when we can be in the same room, because I miss hanging out with you, buddy. It's good to see you.
But then tomorrow.
Tomorrow we will be in, what's it called? Turk?
I can't pronounce the name of the town, to be honest with you.
Truscott,
heard of it before.
Texas. For you and I,
I've heard of every town, not that one.
Yeah, we're the guinea pigs. We're the first ones, I believe, trying and attempting a drive-in, drive-up concert. Man, are you nervous? I'm nervous.
I'm more nervous about how drunk my guys are going to get. They've been cooped up too long.
Yeah, we played.
Those guys are like a bunch of wild-ass Indians.
We played Wednesday at Lava Cantina for a live stream, man. And it was really fun. I will say, man, it's going to be really good for you to see everybody again like we did. The band and crew and everybody, we just had so much fun. At least getting back together and getting back on stage.
I had brought the bus out to Eastland because I've got some workers out there working on the house. And when we were, they needed a place to stay. So I brought the bus out there for them. And when I walked on, I hadn't been on it in like a month, and I walked on like the first time, I was like, oh, it was like weird. And I was like, this is so small.
Yeah. It's a drastic change, right? To go back to it. Cause we're so used to being on the road, and then now we're so used to being home. It's
right.
Messing with our heads for sure.
I've enjoyed the time off, man. I've been in a lot of self-reflecting, and I'm disconnected.
Literally, you disconnected, right?
And
Turning off your phone, right? Like just shutting off your phone and getting away from it for a while.
Not really disconnected that way. I'm just kind of like, man, if the music business shut down, there's no sense of, I'm just kind of dropped out because I can, because there's no, you know, people talking and all that. People talk every day about what's going to happen. No one knows. It's like,
no, yeah.
Nothing to talk about. So
no one knows at all.
Kinda,
yeah.
I'm just kind of, you know, focused on my family and myself and, you know, reevaluated a lot of things. And man, it's been good. It's been really good for me. So
good, man.
Trying to find at least some good positives out of this weird ordeal.
Yeah, man. And there's a lot of good that comes out of it. I mean, I've got kids and my wife, and we've really enjoyed the time. I mean, I've tried to remind myself that when we come back, it's going to be insane, running a rat race, trying to keep up with everything. So
yeah.
Try to enjoy the time when we can, you know.
You want to know what I just realized?
What?
This is the first time ever you have looked down while you're talking to me. Normally you're doing this.
No, that's not true at all. Will, I look down when I talk down to you all the time.
I said, talk to you, but this is the first time you've been able to look down and talk to me. Normally you're like this.
Well, hold on now. Hold on. I'm not Kyle Park now. Come on. I'm not that short. How tall are you?
I'm 6'2".
I'm 5'10". You got 4 inches on me? You're not a giant, for crying out loud.
Hey, don't talk down to me like that. I see you looking down at me.
Is that like Pat Green? When Pat Green hugs me on stage, I disappear for a few seconds. Hey, okay, Will, here's the deal. We're going to chat a lot tonight. And I, by the way, thank you very much for taking time out of your day. I know we don't have a lot going on, but it means a lot you doing this. Our previous guests have been Cody Canada and Jack Ingram and Randy Rogers, and the list goes on and on. We've had a lot of people. And so I try to call on the people that I know they're good buddies. I try to call on the people that are my friends, and also people that I really dig what they do. And I want the people that follow us, whether they know of you or vice versa, if your fans may or may not know who I am. So this is a chance for us to talk about music, man. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to talk music. We're going to play music. We're going to have some fun. And we're here for the long haul.
What's the cursing thing on? What's your cursing rule on this thing?
Well, I mean, I think you're okay if you want to. We're on.
So it's just
Facebook.
So bizarre hearing you every time you you're thanking me, which I do appreciate. But, 30 seconds ago before you were calling me a dipshit. So, I mean, it's.
I didn't call you that. I just was thinking it.
I know you were.
No, for those of you out there, what we dealt with for the last hour is just a pure-blooded redneck.
The whole debacle?
Pure-blooded redneck. That's what makes him William Clark Green to us. He was actually going to do it from his phone, and we were like, let's try a computer. You went and borrowed a computer, right? You don't even have a computer.
I got back in the house, realized I don't have internet.
I texted your manager and said,
"Hey, get my iPad and turn it on, and then figure out how to do the hotspot." And then the code was 3 miles long, and it's just like, what the hell?
Well, I'll tell you this much. I told your manager Dave. I said, "Hey, Dave, what's up? You can't buy your boy a laptop, for crying out loud. He's a grown ass man." And Dave said, "I can buy him one if you want, but he'll just break it in a few hours." And I believe that. You just break it. So don't go buy a computer. You're good. You can borrow one. Hey, and every week I have asked and begged my guest to kick it off for us. So I got a lot of requests for you here.
I can't see any of y'all's comments, by the way. So
yeah, I'm letting you know. I promise. We got some questions lined up, but my mother, Rose Queen, can you believe somebody asked for She Likes the Beatles? Caroline,
the only song they
know. When I was before. Anyway, it's really up to you, man. Play what you want. I'm just giving you some of these that the people have asked for out there. And
I'll take the first one. I think my mother was the first request on that, so.
Awesome. Yeah, y'all keep sending your requests in, and let us know what you want to hear from William Clark Green and myself, and we'll have some fun. Y'all say hello. Welcome to Wade's World, the ultimate corn stream. My good buddy, Mr. William Clark Green.
You always had my back. Every time hey, Wade, can you please not look at your phone while I'm playing?
I'm looking at questions. Get used to it, buddy.
You always had my
I gotta work.
Every time I fall from busted knees to broken hearts, we've been through it all. You made me walk the land. Every time I'm coming off the trail, my mother's always been a better half. From my first shoe you tied to my first night in jail, you walked me through hand in hand the rainbows and the hell. You say I got your ass, I say I've got more than that. My mother's always been my better half. Slow down your drinking and lay down those cigarettes. start thinking about the things you will regret and find a good one. Baby, get lucky like your dad. My mother's always been a better half. You bought me my guitar. Better grades in school. I took it off to college. And I took it for tour. And now the name that you gave is now my autograph. My mother's always been my better half. So down to drinking. And lay down those cigarettes and start thinking about the things you will regret and find a good one. Maybe get lucky like your dad, but my mother's always been. My mother's always been song out to Mama Bowen, except that she's watching.
Yeah, always. She's always watching, of course. Awesome, man. That's a great song.
Microphone messing up again, or is it sound okay?
You're good, man. It's live stream, and it is what it is. Everybody's loving it. No, it sounds great. It sounds great. Hey, I'm sure your mom and everybody, your management, everybody's proud that you're actually just on here at all, you know?
A computer?
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, what are you drinking?
It's crazy. I got to the keyboard to type in my email address, and I was like, how does this work again? I didn't use a keyboard. I couldn't even say the last time I used a keyboard. I was like, how does this? My fingers know what to do, but my brain, how is this working?
Well, I'm glad you figured it out, man.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. I know you've been like hungover today and didn't want to deal with it. So thank you very much.
Worst hangover.
Hey, whose computer did you borrow? Give your buddy a shout out.
Actually, it's Scott and Neil. I don't think he's watching. But Scott used to, I think he's watching some show with his girlfriend, but he lives down the street. It's funny, I was at Home Depot and there was this girl, really pretty girl in front of me at the paint line. And it was right when the quarantine started. And so I was at Home Depot getting some stuff because I just completely destroyed my house. My house is a train wreck. And so we were both in the paint line. And I was kind of like, and she kind of walks off. And then you could see, like, she hollers at this guy. And I was like, oh, here comes her loser boyfriend, you know. And it was my buddy. And I was like, well, since it's him, Scott Neal, he used to play lead guitar for Six Market Boulevard.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And we were bullshitting, and then I was like, where do you live at? He's like, I was like, where'd you move to? I was like, I live in the kind of TCU area. And he's like, oh, I live over there too. And so it turns out he lives four houses down.
Wow.
Yeah.
But so, you have land out like near Abilene, is that right?
Eastland, yeah. So my mom's side of the family, that's where I lived out there for about 7 years. I moved to Fort Worth about 2 years ago, which was bizarre. I kind of did it because I had a girlfriend at the time that didn't want to live in Eastland. And I kind of like Fort Worth. I do miss being out in the country, but it's Fort Worth's a really great town, honestly. It really is.
And I love Fort Worth.
Any city, if I had to live in a city, it would be, out of all of them in Texas, like major city, Fort Worth's the only one I can handle. It is.
Yeah, I've always said if I didn't live in New Braunfels, I'd live in Fort Worth. I love Fort Worth.
It's a great
town.
I love
every time I get to go. We just have nights where we just lay over there and hang out. You know, it's just a beautiful, beautiful town, beautiful people, and there's always something fun. It's our kind of speed, you know.
For
Dallas
sure.
is a little too fast for me, so I like the laid-back feel of Fort Worth.
Yeah, and it's what's great about it is an hour. It's 2 hours from my parents' house. It's an hour to the farm. So, and the bus is, you know, bus stays here. So it's just super convenient. So
yeah. All right, man. Well, we're gonna song swap for a while. You cool with hanging out?
Yeah.
Hey, and by the way, when I'm checking my phone, I know it's normally rude, but I have to make sure I watch the comments.
I'm just giving you so, hell, Wade.
I normally preface that with when I get somebody on and let them kind of give them a warning, like, hey, I'm listening, but I didn't get to do that with you because we were scrounging around for a computer, damn it. So I didn't get to give you my warning.
We should have recorded that debacle. That debacle was ridiculous.
That would have been. We should have gone live an hour ago, and just so people could see us try to figure this out. But hey, if it makes you feel any better, yeah. It was the same way with Sean McConnell last week, but it was about 3 hours. Because he lives out in the sticks outside of Nashville. And it took everything we could to try to figure it out. So, hey, man, it's the times we're in. It's adjusting and moving on and figuring this out. I mean, that's what we're going to be doing for a long time with our careers, unfortunately. So,
it ain't the first time I've been cussed at by Wade Bowen.
It won't be the last.
And it won't be the last.
Will not be the last. All right, man. I'm going to do this when I saw this request pop up first, so. So long, Sixth Street. Yeah, I think it's time. I'm all out of quarters to play. I'm all out of rhymes. I got a few loose strings. I'm gonna have to leave behind. Please don't hold it against me. I think we both know why. I think we both know why. So long, Sixth Street. Gonna miss you under my feet. But sometimes I gotta run till I can find a heartbeat. Tell it up when you see. Heard that I was too weak. What a looker in the eye. I hate it when she cries anyway. Well, anyway, I think she's probably better off without me. So sell on Sixth Street. I'm gonna miss you under my feet. Yeah, so long, Antone. Oh, it's you I'll miss some more. I've stumbled on from your arms. How many times I just don't know. Maybe you can leave a light on. In case I come back around. On my way to looking for me in some lost and found town. So long, Sixth Street. Gonna miss you under my feet. Well, sometimes I gotta run to. I can find a heartbeat. Tell it up when you see. Heard that I was too weak. Well, to look her in the eye. Hate her when she cries anyway. Well, anyway, I think she's probably better off without me. So long, Sixth Street. So long, Sixth Street. I'm gonna miss you under my feet. Oh, yeah. Well, so long, so long, Sixth Street. Gonna miss you under my feet. Well, sometimes I gotta run. Run till I can find a heartbeat. Tell it up when you see. Heard that I was too weak. Well, to look her in the eye. Hate her when she cries anyway. Well, anyway, I think she's probably better off without me. So long, Sixth Street. Gonna miss you under my feet. Yeah, so long, Sixth Street. I can hear you.
We were in Austin together. You walked down Sixth Street with a pizza. A large pizza, and you're holding it like the wrong way.
I was holding it like a briefcase.
You can't see at my show. and I didn't know you were there, and you came up to me behind me, and you grabbed my boobs, and you started squeezing them for like a minute, like uncomfortably too long. And I'm sitting there like, hey, get the fuck off the stage, like trying to smile, you know, and like play, put a good Parker face. And
I don't believe you.
And then you started like doing this, and I was like, get out of here.
I don't believe you. Nobody believes you.
Well,
hey, man, we have fun together. That's all that matters. I did. I walked down 6th Street with to the bus with the pizza like a briefcase. I had to pick it up and pass out slices to homeless people, and they were loving it. I was the king of the world that night.
Oh, that's awesome.
All thanks to you. All thanks to the good time I had at your show.
That was fun. We all scooted in on the east side.
You got the Music Cares thing queued up there, Tim? Music Cares, that shorter one? Cool. All right. We've been doing this for 9 weeks, so if you've tuned in before, thank you for the donations and stuff that you've made. We've been able to give quite a bit of money to Music Cares. And this is just some more info on where the money goes and what they do.
We are producers,
engineers,
singers,
songwriters,
musicians,
tour and live production crew,
and thousands more of us.
Without us, the music stops.
We need your help
to keep the music playing.
Support those impacted today at musiccares.org.
Music Cares, that's a little bit about of what we're going. We'll get into it more. We've got another video later on that we'll show and that explains Music Cares in detail. Of what Music Cares really does. It's a great, great organization that I cannot say enough great things about. So there's a lot of musicians really struggling right now in the world. A lot of people struggling. We know it's not just musicians, but you know, a lot of our friends, a lot of our artist friends, a lot of our musician buddies, and a lot of the bars, the venues are really struggling. It's just a crazy time. We all know it's crazy. It's been crazy for 3 months now. We were thinking about it, Will, the other day. We got together with the band and it was so much fun, but we realized we hadn't played since early March, so it's been almost 3 months since we played a full band show.
Yeah, I started a week before everybody because I was in Mexico for a week doing an acoustic show, and so when I landed back, I mean it was everything. We canceled our shows that weekend.
Yeah,
I had a bad cough, which might have been it. You know, I had a bad cough, and with this stuff going on, we're supposed to play down in Concan. And I was like, I'm not going to be coughing on stage. Like we're canceling. Like, I wasn't sick, but I was coughing. And I'm like, I'm not going to be coughing on stage. So.
That was Concan?
Yeah, Concan. Yeah. Yeah, and Cody filled in. So it worked out. It worked out for him, worked out for us. But yeah, it's just weird.
Yeah.
It's weird. I don't, no one has really the right answers. I think. It's kind of unique though that we live in a country where people are upset that they can't work their asses off. You know, I think that's pretty cool.
Yeah,
and it's been extremely. I mean, for me, I'm sure other people have been extremely uncomfortable, but for me, I mean, it's like being, you got roof over your head. I mean, grocery stores are open. You know, you got hot water. I mean, there's a lot of. It could be way worse. I mean, it could be electricity. I mean, there's a lot of things that amenities we have to be comfortable during this. And it's to me, you know, I'm not speaking for everybody, but for me, it's, you know, money's one thing, but I mean, it is what it is, you know, on that
front. It is what it is. Yeah. It is what it is. And I get it. And that's a great way to look at it. And I think there's a lot of people that either look at it that way or they look at it the complete opposite. They're in denial or scared to death. But
if I had children, I would be probably speaking a different tune, you know?
Well, not really. I mean, I'm with you on that. I mean, I just try to, you know, there's nothing you can do about it. Even with kids, it is what it is, you know, and with everything in life, you just pick up and try to figure out how to make the best of every situation. And it sounds like you're doing that. You know, do you have you have a different booking agency than I do and different management. I'm just curious, you know, there's a lot of people. I just saw Maren Morris canceled her tour for the rest of the year. I saw Kenny Chesney just canceled his tour. I know that Pearl Jam is canceled. Everybody's pretty much canceled their major tours. I'm just curious what you're hearing, or do y'all have a plan of when you think you might come back or any of that?
The only thing that I've heard is that there are bands. A buddy of mine owns a venue, which we all know, you know, people who own venues. He owns a venue that books a lot of Nashville acts. It's a smaller club, but they book a lot of Nashville acts. They're about 30% Texas country and about, you know, 70% Nashville. And they said he's getting offers for Midland to play, like on $20 tickets.
Yeah.
And they just want to play.
Just want to get out and play, yeah.
And it's under a 1,000-seat club. And so either one or two things going to happen where, you know, no one over 1,000 people ever comes watch us play, so.
That is not true.
That'll be good. But the other problem with that is that if all these acts like Midland and these bigger acts that play, you know, sell out Billy Bob's and play smaller arena type stuff, if they start coming down to our level, it's either going to do one of two things. It's going to push us out, or it's going to have us support with them, which could be cool. If we're supporting those bands, I mean, it'd be awesome.
So, yeah, it would be. You know, you start, you know, the financial side of all of that is a nightmare. And it's a nightmare for the venues, too. And you don't want to, you know, it's a fine line between you don't want to devalue your worth in a city or anywhere you play. But at the same time, desperate times, you know, desperate measures, right?
And, I mean, this gig that we're playing on tomorrow, I mean, shoot, it's we're not making any money on it, but my guys are getting paid anyway, so, and it'll be fun. I think it'll be great just to get, I mean, honestly, I have no idea what to expect tomorrow. I don't know if you do.
I don't really know
that much about it. I know it's for a good cause, and I hope it's in the middle of nowhere, and I hope it goes off without a hitch, but, we're doing this for pretty much selfish reasons, just for the mere fact of like, man, it would be really fun to just go do it again once, you know? And so when we're playing to people in cars, but I'm looking forward to seeing you, and more so I'm looking forward to seeing your crew and your band, all the people that are way cooler than you. And
me too, man. I couldn't agree more.
And the production guys and everything, you know, it's going to be fun. My guys, I have not seen, I got, man, me and Steve and Josh last night lost some brain cells. But I got plenty of them in my system after last night. But I'm looking forward to seeing, you know, all my guys and bus driver and, you know, hope, for God forbid the bus breaks down. I mean, it's just like, I don't even know. I'd be like, I just have to quit.
when was the last time you cranked up the bus?
I ran it out in Eastland, and I cranked it. I had to jump it. It was dead. But
yeah, same here.
I had it out in Eastland. I cranked it. Ran it for about a day. So
it'll run. It'll be fine.
Eastland and Fort Worth.
It's going to be fun, man. And I saw that they're doing some at the new Rangers parking lot out there. They're doing a bunch of our buddies are playing out there for drive-up concerts. And, you know, I guess it's the thing for a while. I think those will pop up here and there. I don't think they're going to help us make a living or anything, kind of like these live streams, man. At first nobody was doing it, and then everybody jumped on, and now everybody's doing it, and it's the thing to do,
right?
So I think those shows like we're doing tomorrow will be that for a little bit, and, you know, hey, we'll make the best of them as we've done everything.
Yeah, and I think that's the thing about it is no one is able to do anything but that, so doing that is just what you got to do. And yeah. So to watch a show, if you want to see a concert, either it's either going to be in a car or on a laptop. And, you know, we're not making the rules. We're just
doing the best we can.
Yeah.
You know, we want to go play too.
And our industry is going to be the last one back at it. I mean, we're going to be the last one. And I mean, not to complain or sound like I'm complaining, but no one's going to give a shit about our industry either. You know what I mean? It's not a necessity industry, and it's not like it's honestly doesn't seem real to a lot of people in the first place. So we're not going to get a lot of love in that department. They're going to shut it. It is what it is. And I don't think packing venues full of thousands of people right now might not be the best idea, but
right.
You know,
one thing I have found is that people still want the music as bad as ever, maybe more than ever. So
yeah. That's
why these things are great. Thanks for being a part of this tonight, man. It's bringing people some joy.
I've noticed with this whole deal, man, I know it's easy to look at the negative side of things, but man, my neighbor cooks me lunch like every day because I'm home and she brings me fresh eggs. I got to know all my other neighbors I've never met. And like I've seen so much good with people. And people coming out of people,
Yeah.
I just sing so much good. I mean, of course there's bad everywhere, but especially when all you hear is the bad, because that's what gets the most attention. But man, people are being awesome. Especially in our scene, no one's bitched about anything. I haven't heard anybody complain. No production guys. Nobody's demanding.
You had talked to Randy Rogers? You must not talk to Randy. You must not talk to Randy Rogers. You know, you know he's complaining. I'm just kidding, Randy. I love you. Hey, Will. Here's a question I got for you. If let's say we know this is not going to happen, okay? But let's just say we never get to play music again. You got to go figure something out for about 5 years. What would you do besides drink Pedialyte? What would you have to do, or what would you want to do besides music?
Well, I've been remodeling the house. I've really enjoyed it. Robert Gallagher at with Billy Bob's. I'm going to help him do the same with his house. I'm not going to charge him, but I would love to be a contractor. I think I'd be a good one.
You want to come down to New Braunfels, and I got some work you can do.
Wait, I've seen your house. That house don't need no work.
Yeah, it does. Hey, the Chinese proverb, the only man who's done with his working on his house is a dead man.
If you walked into my house, you'd be like, you're living here?
Whatever. Well, play us a song, man.
Well, whatever. You have to answer the question. What would you do?
Oh, gosh. Believe me, I've thought about it. You know, when you have kids and you start going, okay, this may be for real. I've done a lot of begging to some other people. Hey, keep me in mind. I might be hitting you up here in a few weeks for a job.
The good thing about our industry is the amount of friends that we've made. I mean, you know, our social lives are pretty extravagant compared to other people's, you know, because what's what we do for a living. We entertain and we socialize. Yeah. And so, I'm sure something could pop up, you know, with any of us, you know. So.
I'd probably go call my brother-in-law in Waco, Texas, and help him with Bowen Electric.
There you go. That's not a bad idea. I might be.
I told him I can dig ditches all day, man.
I can do electrician or plumbing or run my own business. I mean, Donahue, well, I guess I probably shouldn't say that, but a friend of mine said that he was thinking about doing some dirt work.
He was also talking about doing a lawn service where we sing to you afterwards. And I was like, man, I'll do it. Whatever it takes, man.
You know, and here's what I think is going to happen at backyard parties. I mean, I think we're in backyard parties will be fine. And I'm not worried about the outlet. I just think, like I said, we're kind of the last ones to get figured out. So, do we have any requests or anything?
Yeah, man. We got a lot of requests. Caroline, Misunderstood.
Misunderstood. I'm doing my love. So, shameless plug. Okay. Next week, I'm doing the entire Misunderstood record on Wade Bone Instagram page.
Please, I need all the help I can get.
What day
do you do those? You do live streams kind of whenever, right?
I try to do one a week. And
what day are you doing it next week? Do you know?
I don't know what day, but Wednesday or Thursday.
Okay.
My birthday is next week. I don't know what day it is. Day is farthest away from the day after my birthday, I'd say.
Okay. That's probably best for everybody.
This is my song. This is a song that I wrote about Kylie Rae Harris a long time ago. And it's one of my favorite songs to play. And she also sang the harmony song.
And it's her birthday today.
Say what?
It's her birthday today.
Is it really?
Yeah, isn't that crazy?
I was thinking about her today. I felt it.
Yep. Her and Steve Helms.
Well, no one cares about Steve. I miss Kylie. She's always so much fun to be around.
She was a
good-hearted person too. The song goes out to her now for her birthday.
I've been thinking about you and me and all this time we spent together. I got a feeling that I can't you see. It's all good, but you better all these days gonna get it right. You're going to be in the creek, don't dance. You've been running to find yourself, now that you found the way back home. You've been missing me, can't you tell? Ain't no reason to keep you and me, baby, going out tonight. Good Lord, we're in the creek.
Are you like no. a Facebook checker? A friend of mine is, he remembers all of his friends' birthdays. I was like, that's really cool.
I have some of them written, you know, in my phone, and I get the Facebook alerts every morning, which I really like. That really helps me a lot.
Yeah.
But man, I try really hard, try really hard to remember, but it's tough.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw some people commenting on Facebook today about Kylie Rae and Steve Elms.
And maybe I saw something and that's what I was thinking of her about that. But yeah, I was thinking about her today.
Say what? You did, man. I bet you did. Yeah, it's in the air. That's cool. Yeah.
So I've got a request for you.
Okay.
My favorite song is "You Had Me at My Best." Can you play that song today, or is it? I know that song is up there on the register. I can't sing that song. Or actually, I'll take that back.
I've got three songs that are up there on the register. It's "You Had Me My Best." It's hard to sing every night.
West Texas Rain.
West Texas Rain and So Long Sixth Street. Those three.
I'd like to hear West Texas Rain or "You Had Me My Best." I'll let you pick.
We'll do both of them before the night's up. How about that? But thanks for asking. I'll do this one. I don't think I've done this one on the Wade's World yet. Can you believe that? In the corner of my living room lies the rain she threw behind. I can't bring myself to pick it up, you know she still might change her mind. Every morning around 6 a.m., the sun hits it just right. And I'll spend another day in hell waiting on the night. See the way people look at me, I guess it's all over my face. Scar above my left eye is something I just can't erase. I try to look at someone else's mirror, try to find a different view. Oh, it's really sad to say, but it's all I got left for you. Yeah, well, I'm a lone survivor of wreckage that is left. Yeah, well, I brought the walls down, baby. I made all this mess. One line in the ashes, I must confess. Girl, you had me at my best. Pain sometimes disappears, but your memories never gone. Now I'm myself in my bedroom, cause it's best if I'm alone. And I've been falling asleep in my old chair with the TV on. Cause my bed won't let me sleep, cause love is all it's known. Yeah, well, I'm a lone survivor of wreckage that. Yeah, well, I brought the walls down, baby. I made all this mess. Oh, lying in the ashes, I must confess. Girl, you had me at my best. Yeah, well, I'm the lone survivor of the wreckage that is left. Yeah, well, I brought the walls down, baby. I made all this mess. Oh, and lying in the ashes, I must confess. Girl, you had me at my best. Yeah, you had me at my best. Girl, you had me at my best. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Hey, you know, when you're singing, I feel like that guy that's right way too close in the front row that's staring at you the whole show. And like, when you look down, make eye contact, you, it's like awkward for a second. You're like,
hey, it's hard to get used to the virtual no clapping and the virtual like back and forth, right? It's hard to get used to it.
Yeah. What's going to happen tomorrow night? They're just going to start honking. They're going to be honking their horns the whole show.
I think they're going to honk. That's the only thing that's the only thing I know that.
And flash your lights.
Yeah. Flash your lights and honk a lot, I guess.
Dude. How many people are going to have sex in their cars? I mean, I'm serious.
I don't know. That's a good question. Isn't that why you go to the drive-in?
No comment, I guess.
You want to do a virtual shot? It's a Wade's World tradition. Tonight I'm drinking George Strait's tequila, Codigo.
I've heard that's really good.
It's good. I like it. This is the Añejo.
If I take a shot of anything, I'll throw up. I'm going to stick to my PB light.
Got my usual Skull shot glass. All right.
Hey, who'd you write that song with, by the way?
You Had Me at My Best?
Yeah.
I wrote that song with my buddy Jed Hughes.
Man, it's such a great song.
He wrote that guitar lick, too. That's actually what he wrote the guitar lick first.
I'm not surprised at all.
Yeah, he wrote that guitar lick first, and then we wrote the rest of the song.
I mean, that guitar lick is so awesome. My favorite line is when he goes, I don't know which one of y'all wrote it, but my favorite line is, my bed won't let me sleep because love is all it's known. Like, that's so good.
Heart wrencher.
So good.
All right, virtual shot, my friend.
Cheers.
Thanks to William Clark Green for being my guest on Wade's World. Ooh, here we go. This is either be the beginning or the end of the show. Y'all can figure that out.
Hey, we need to talk to somebody about lowering the prices of PD Line. This stuff's like $6 a jug. It's ridiculous. $6 a liter.
Hey, man. So, Will, I've got a video pulled up here. Last week, I featured on Wade's World. I didn't have any guests. Actually, I had a lot of guests. All my guests were the songwriters from Hold My Beer Volume 2, which was released last week.
Oh, and cool. Congrats, by the way.
Thank you. Yeah.
It's awesome. I've got some buddies that got some co-writes on that record. They're very proud of it. So
yeah, man. That's what actually Ross Cooper is who we're going to talk about because I downloaded all the videos and went to people live and tried all the stuff, but Ross has got messed up somehow and didn't make it over. So we got it figured out, hopefully, right? Is it working? It's not upside down. All this broadcasting stuff I'm trying to become a tech nerd, Will, but it's not working out very well. Ross Cooper wrote a song on the record. He wrote Let Merle Be Merle with a couple other people, and he's going to talk about that. And he's got a great record out. I know you guys have written some songs together, and he's a fellow West Texas guy. You want to talk any more about Ross Cooper? I mean, I know you guys are real good buddies.
So Ross is the complete opposite of me. So Ross grew up in Lubbock and went to college at College Station at Texas A&M. I grew up in College Station and went to school in Lubbock.
So smart man, smart man.
So, well, I would not say that. But me and him have been buddies for years, and he's just such a good guy. And we were at Ringling Road together. Rick wrote Donner together. Written a bunch of songs. Written quite a bit of songs together. So people that are listening, so sometimes when you write with someone, it doesn't always work out. But with me and Ross, when we write one-on-one, it never really works out. When we work in threes, we do threesomes, it's always badass. It's like we're like 4 for 4.
That's interesting. Why that is.
I think it's because we're really close.
Yeah, and it's hard to like.
We want to not agree with each other, and the third person is kind of that third
middle ground. Yeah, I like that. That's cool. He's a fantastic dude, and I really love his stuff, man. And I'm so glad. Actually, I'm kind of glad it worked out that his video didn't work last week, so we could kind of talk more about him this week, because you guys are so close, and I just think it like worked out perfectly for him to be a part of our show tonight. So.
Man, he's a great dude, a great songwriter, and he loves writing. He loves crafting songs. He's a good friend. Comes from a great family. Is beautiful. Been recently married. Beautiful bride.
Yes. Great dude.
Yeah.
Here's our buddy. Here's our buddy Ross Cooper.
Hey, what's up, Wade? How's it going, amigo? Thank you so much for having me on Wade's World, man. First and foremost, big congratulations to you and Randy. Happy release day to you. Pretty exciting deal. I just got my package in the mail a couple days ago that had the record in it, and I've been kind of over the moon about it. Honestly, I've kind of grew up with your songs, with Randy's songs, and been listening to them since high school. So for me to have a really, really, really small part in this album is kind of a really big deal for me. So thank you guys. I'm honored. So the song, Let Merle Be Merle, I wrote that with three other buddies. Casey Twist, who a lot of you know as a great bass player who's played with the likes of Jack Ingram, you, Gavin DeGraw, Stoney LaRue, and then a laundry list of other gigs, I'm sure. But he's also a fantastic songwriter. Another guy that was in on that co-write was Josh Abbott from the Josh Abbott Band, a man who certainly needs no introduction. Myself, and then our friend Randall Clay. So the idea for the song, me and Randall, we'd just written a song with William Clark Green. We'd just written the song Ringling Road, and we were leaving Music Row, and we were heading to Midtown, to Red Door, to go celebrate. And in my old conversion van, I had a tape player in it, and I had a Merle Haggard tape. And we were listening to Merle Haggard, and we were driving down Music Row, and passing all the yards of the publishing companies with the banners, in the yard that are congratulating the songwriters on the top 40 cuts or whatever. And we were talking about the state of country music and how it was poppy and et cetera. And I said something offhand, just kind of, let them have it, let pop be pop, but let Merle be Merle. And I wasn't even thinking about it when I said it, but Randall caught it, and he said, man, that sounds like a song title that we should write. And so, fast forward a couple of months, Randall and I got together, and we started writing the song. Well, coincidentally, Josh and Casey were across town at Warner, and they were writing. So we texted them to see if they wanted to join us, and we all got together and wrote Let Merle Be Merle. So then fast forward like 5 years, and Casey texted me just kind of out of the blue and said, hey, man, Let Merle Be Merle is getting cut, and Wade and Randy are cutting it. And so we were we were over the moon excited about it. Unfortunately, Randall didn't get to live long enough to see the song get cut. Randall passed away a couple years ago, but I can honestly tell you he is the sole reason that this song exists, outside of catching, the idea out of just something that I said offhand. He kind of steered the ship on that right, and, the guy was just He's a great guy, a big character, and had such a grasp and a command on songwriting and on perspective and voice in songs. And he really was a songwriter and a master craftsman of songs. So If he were here, I think that I could speak for all of us, though, in saying that I don't think two better guys could have cut this song. Absolutely honored, man. Really, really cool deal. So, again, happy release day to you guys. So, anyway, when you hollered at me about being on Wade's World, I was trying to kind of rack my brain about what song I would play. And I do have a new album coming out that could be later this fall or could be beginning of next year. It's just, you know, kind of up in the air with all the quarantine stuff. So, remains to be seen. But I'll go ahead and play a song off my last record. The song is called Strangers in a Bar. Long blonde 20 something standing at the bar. You're rebel with a smoke that's in your hand. You're taking pride in that no one understands. You, and you should come with a warning. Be alone in the morning. You're fishing for the first of many greens. Hooking fools on the first of many wings. Quoting books nobody reads to a man who needs relief. So I bind your shit and I act interested. We're both players in a game. Ain't we all just the same? Throwing caution to the shame. Forget the wind and rain, cause by ourselves we might be lonesome. But we don't have to be alone. Dust bowl and dirt farmer wet behind the ears, who can't afford this drink that's in my hand. But I'm acting cool cause I sing in a band. And I come with a disclaimer just to show my nature, even though my intentions are wrong. It's either you or the next who comes along. Quoting songs nobody's heard to a girl and her last nerve. You see through my charm, you're still on my arm. We're strangers at a bar, having bitter heart to hearts. And now we can take my car, I'll show you where I park. Cause by ourselves, we might be lonesome. But we don't have to be alone. Thanks again, man. I hope to see y'all both very, very, very soon. Congratulations, and everybody, as soon as you get the chance, go and get you a copy of Hold My Beer, Volume 2.
Well, Ross Cooper, always good to hear him, man. Thank you, Ross, again for being one of the writers on Hold My Beer Volume 2. We really appreciate it, man. It means a lot. You really wrote a great song and a huge part of our record, man. So thank you so much. I look forward to writing. Let's do a writing session with you and I and Ross.
Oh, that'll be an argument.
That'd be fun. Well, we won't agree on anything.
We would never.
Man, you got a song lined up. You got a new song coming out, right?
Well, we have a new single coming. We have a new single, but it's from our record, Aber Island.
And
it's called Poor. And wrote it with Dalton Domino.
And, love Dalton.
I'm assuming you want me to play it, right?
Yeah, that'd be good. Yeah. You play whatever you want, though.
All right. So our buddy Kyle Weeders, he said, I need to scoot back 5 feet. So I'm going to try to scoot back so Kyle can see my guitar while I'm playing.
There you go.
That's good enough for you, Kyle.
That's perfect.
I sure would hate for you to feel like you didn't get your money's worth on this deal. I'm a sucker, sinner, three times a loser, who can't buy you from me. You're a lady, saint, three times I ain't sure about where I don't care for the bills and the bills. I don't care for your debt. To me, imagine covering up in your hair, and it feels pretty good, yeah. If you pass it and seal, my love's feeling, but why do you stuck in the rain? You have a smile, and think for a while, and you're dreaming of me. I don't care for the bills and the mailbox. You don't care for the cars on the lawn. To me in my bed, waking up to this mess, and it feels pretty good.
Hey, get back closer. It sounds better when you're closer. Don't listen to Kyle.
Oh, God. Where's Tim? He sounds about this guy.
No, no, that's me. I'm telling. Don't listen to Weeders. Get closer so we can hear you better.
That dude has one ridiculously cute kiddo and thinks he's cool.
He does that. All right. So I've got a shout out here. We have... There's a couple of people, three of them, but the two ladies are twins from Michigan. I think they come to your shows quite a bit.
Oh, yeah. I know them.
Yeah. So Janice and Julie they reached out. I guess Janice is in the hospital right now. She's having some heart issues or something, and she had a procedure this morning, and supposedly she's going to be watching tonight.
Awesome. Well, hello. I know that. I'm so sorry that you had to...
I think everything went successful this morning from what I've heard. And her husband, Jeff, I believe we've been hearing from them that everything went great too. So Julie, her sister's been keeping us up to date with everything. So, she asked for some of our songs, man. They live in Michigan, but they
come to so many shows.
They travel to Texas twice or two or three times a year
and
follow us all around. And they're great, great human beings. And we're so sorry to hear that you're in the hospital, but we're so glad everything went great. And
supposedly, that sounds like good news.
Supposedly you want to hear this one here. So here you go. Straight, I'm lonely as hell, and there's nothing I can do. And Emptiness comes over me as I sit here thinking about you. I take my boots off, set them on the floor next to my bed. I try to fall asleep, but I'll just end up laying there instead. Oh, why do you wait for me, lonely? Why do I miss you only? Why do we hold out just one kiss? Yeah, 'cause why makes perfect sense. Yeah, well, it's been 20 days. I bet you woke up bright and early, right on time. I know it's hard to start your day when the only thing to hold is a telephone line. Yeah, tomorrow'll be the same, and every day until I'm done. But I'll make sure and make it home to you, girl, just as fast as I can run. Whoa, why do you wait for me, lonely? Why do I miss you? Thank you. No, I haven't played that one in a while with the band.
I forgot how great that song is, man. You should definitely, you know, I mean, what do I know? I just write songs too, but that's a great song. You should put that back in your set.
Thanks, man.
Awesome. I'll talk to the band. I forgot about that one, man. That's a sleeper.
Sleeper. That's by a request good one. From Michigan. So let's see here. I got some questions. You cool? A few questions here?
Depends on what the answer they're looking for.
Let's see here. Jennifer wants to know, is there a story or a real girl behind the song I Still Think About You?
Yes.
Perfect.
No, there is.
Moving on.
It's about an ex of mine. She's from Hondo, Texas. She's a great girl, honestly. I just was young and wasn't ready to have that part of my life yet. And then it really came. I wrote the chorus, and I sent it to a dear friend of mine that he does. He's a songwriter in New Braunfels. He does like this podcast thing that he does on some nights and has like people coming in. I won't mention his name, but he's another songwriter. His name starts with a W, and he's like Shiner Beer and stuff. But I sent it to him to write with me, and he told me he didn't like the song. And so I was like, oh, okay. Well, then, I called a couple other guys. No one liked it. Well, I was in Steamboat, Springs, Colorado, and Kent Finley was dying of cancer. And I went to his condo to write with him because he couldn't get out of the house. And so I went to go write with him, hang out, and we had lunch, and we just bullshit. Me and him talked about songs a lot. And we used to go out to lunch all the time in San Marcos. And so I went, and we were trying to pick a song, and we were messing around with some stuff. And I was like, I got this song no one likes. If you want to listen to it. Before I played it, I was kind of nervous because, like I said, my buddy, that his name starts with a W, he thought it was terrible. And so I was kind of embarrassed of it. And so I spoke for him. He goes, man, I love that. And so we finished. We actually wrote that song, a Steamboat. That was the last song I tried with Kent before he passed away, which I'm kind of glad my friend, whose name starts with a W, that lives in New Braunfels, does that podcast thing or this live stuff. I'm actually glad that he didn't choose it because it's really a special song for me and Kent. It's the last song we wrote. And it was meant to be that way. And I think Kent, the song meant something to Kent. When we wrote it, I've written quite a bit with Kent. He was pretty, it seemed like that song meant a lot to him for some, maybe in his past. So,
well, it's a good song and he probably felt really confident about it. He saved it for sure. Right.
I'm just it says kidding. The word bastard in it. I remember you were like, I'm not saying that. And I was like, well, it's gotta be that way. So
I think you're talking about Walt Wilkins, right? The other W,
maybe
Willie Braun.
But that song is a special song to me.
Yeah, man. That's cool. Is there anything, Jessica wants to know if there's anything you're binge watching right now. You're not a binge watching guy, are you?
God. So I have stuff to watch. I did the Tiger King. I did the Formula One. I did, what was the other thing that was Tiger King related? It wasn't Tiger, but they were kind of like both binge watched at the same time. But I'm on this show called Revenge. And it's so stupid. It's about the first season was really good, but it's a total chick deal. And the first season was pretty good, and now it's gotten so dumb. It's like kind of like Lost, where they keep going because they're out of ideas, and the show is making money. So the show, it's just like so stupid. And I'm over it though. But that's what I've been watching with Revenge on Hulu.
Don't you hate when you get into something and it's not good, but you feel like you just gotta finish it?
I gotta know.
Thank you to everybody that's donated and tipped every week, or just any week at all. We really appreciate it. We're trying to get Will some gas money before he heads to Truscott, Texas tomorrow for our drive-in show. Once again, you're watching Wade's World, the ultimate corn stream. My buddy William Clark Green is with us tonight. And we love having him. We're asking questions and talking music and having fun.
Having a blast.
Let's see. Jeff says his daughters want to know, what's the first thing you're going to do when quarantine ends?
Go to a bar?
Duh. Easy answer, right?
Come on, Jeff.
What's your first bar to go to?
I don't know. Just depends on where I'm at. I'm still not 100% sure. I'll take that back, Jeff. I'm not 100% sure I'm going to go home and see my parents because my dad is kind of high risk. And I kind of had a scare. My nephew had a fever yesterday. Got tested, and thank God he didn't have it. But I just don't want to be responsible for my dad getting it. And I haven't been, I haven't been as responsible as he needs to be. So I just don't know if I go home. So I'd probably go home and see my folks.
Yeah, man. I think that's what I would do too. I mean, I miss my mom and dad, and they live up in Waco, and I talk to them all the time, and it's really them and my sisters. You know, I don't. It's really crazy that we've hunkered down and done what we're supposed to, but I miss seeing them.
I might belly up at the bar the night before I go home.
what if you go see them first and then go to the bar?
Yeah.
Let's do that. We'll meet up at the bar.
It would just be cool to be around. You know what I realize? This sounds so lame, but I haven't had a hug in a long time. And the music business is full of it. Every time you see someone, and it's like, I saw my mom came to Fort Worth and to pick up some stuff from the farm. And I met her at the Home Depot parking lot, and it was weird. First time, I never hugged my mom. I mean, it was weird. I was like, yeah. Hi. And it was like, I love you. And it was like, it was so bizarre.
It is bizarre. It's a bizarre time, man. It's crazy. Zach doesn't ask a question. He just simply, actually, his question is, more William Clark Green. That's his question. So thank you, Zach, for that amazing question. We will get you some more William Clark Green right here. Will, why don't you play us another song, man?
I'll play a new song, if that's all right.
Yeah, play whatever you want.
Oh man, I'm so full of Pedialyte, I can barely move.
Hey, Will, what's going on? Slate May wants to know, is there anything on rescheduling Cotton Fest?
Well, I mean, it's my festival, so I guess I can say whatever I want to about it, but we're trying for July 4th. We don't think it's going to happen, but we have the date blocked. We don't know. That's all we know. We have not rented stage production or any of that stuff. It's just, we'll see.
Hopefully July 4th. If not, then you'll push it back or just shoot for next year. I mean,
we're not going to interfere with Jab Fest.
Yeah.
I just wouldn't do that to Josh, first of all. And plus, I think we're on it. I don't even know if that's announced, but we're on Jab Fest. it would just be a next year thing. We might try to have a summer show or something. I don't know. We don't know. So
it's hard, man. Yeah. We had to cancel ours too. It's just a crazy time. So good luck with all that, man. I know it's you put a lot of work into that.
You were gonna be there.
You're always there for me, man. I'm always there for you. I'm there for you whenever you say. Just let me know.
Thank you.
Reschedule it. Let me know.
So this is my favorite song I think I've ever. It's like one of the last songs I've written. But I want you to go. All right, man. I'm so hungover. This song is called Anymore, and I wrote it about an ex of mine. And the song is supposed to mimic the Travis Tritt song Anymore, or personal reasons, I guess I'd say that. So that's a favorite song of ours that we used to sing. I wrote this song with Zane Williams and Max Stalling.
Awesome. Good shout out.
Give it your best. Try not to regret the past. It's a give and a take. Some things you just can't take. Pulled you in just to push you away, searching for words that I know I should say, but I wasn't expecting by you leaving today. I don't want you to go. God knows you need to, just so you know. Baby, I love you, and I don't know. House that I bought for you feels like a big waste of space. I took a night off from drinking, finally cleaned up the place. I've tried to be who you want me to be. You've tried to fit in this life that I lead, so let's take a step back. Focus and try to breathe. I don't want you to go. God knows you need to, just so you know. Damn it, I love you, and I don't know why. But I see the night in my eyes. You don't have to
Good song, man.
No furniture in it.
What's that?
So this house sounds pretty good without furniture in it.
Man, that's a great song.
Thank you. I'm proud of that one.
Wade's World, the ultimate corn stream.
Corn stream.
The corn stream, buddy.
I like it. Hopefully we satisfied all of Kyle Weeder's needs.
I want to let you, I want to remind you, as every week, I'm checking these text messages. You can text me at 830-240-7978. And I'm getting them right here. This is a lot of good requests. Will, everybody's loving you, man.
They must not know me yet.
They obviously don't. Sheila Bowler, she wants to hear this one. So thank you, Sheila, for the request. An old school song here. I'm not as good as I advertise. Then again, who really is? Judgment is thrown around so easily, but nobody wants to catch it. They just want to sidestep it. I think I finally had enough. Walking along the fence line, hands in my pockets, got a million things on my mind. Well, I'm not sure what I'm trying to find, so I'll just keep walking, knowing it'll come with time. Just walking along the fence line. Faith and time go hand in hand, and I found along the way that my faith runs deep. Time is no longer one of my concerns. You think I've gone astray, go the wrong way. Why is it so wrong to simply be? Just walking along the fence line, my hands in Well, I'm not sure what I'm trying to find, so I'll just keep walking, knowing it'll come with time. Just walking along the fence line. Where you think I've gone astray, going the wrong way, why is it so wrong to simply be? Just walking along the fence line. Got my hands in my pockets, got a million things on my mind. Well, I'm not sure what I'm trying to find, so I'll just keep walking, knowing it'll come in time. Just walking along the fence line. Just walking along the fence line. Long, yeah, yeah. Just keep walking. Yeah, you just keep on walking. Keep on walking. Thank you. Thanks, Will. Thanks to everybody out there. Virtual round of applause. Y'all get your virtual shots ready. We're going to play the video for Music Cares. This is a fantastic video we found that really sums up what they do. It's a fantastic organization. Tonight, we're raising money for Music Cares, and we're raising money for William Clark Green and his band and his crew that we're all struggling, and our band and crew as well. So feel free, if you're enjoying the show, you want to tip, donate, go to Wade Bowen. .com/tips and feel free to donate there. But we want you to know more about where the money goes and why we think Music Cares is such a fantastic organization. So Wade's World Ultimate Core and Stream, Music Cares, here you go.
October 1st, 2017 is a day that I'll never forget unless you were there and saw and lived through it. And thankfully, all of our people came through it. We've had an unbelievable outpouring from the community. And one of the ones that I want to recognize right off the bat is Music Cares and what they've done to step up and help on so many fronts. The help that you guys have provided and continue to provide for the music community is unparalleled and truly makes a difference.
Winston Churchill once said, "We make a living by what we get, but we make a life out of what we give." I'm grateful, grateful to be of service to this fine organization, Music Cares.
You know, this organization was founded back in 1989 as a result of the fact that the great band leader Woody Herman passed away. When he died, he was broke and alone.
All the great musicians, thank you for contributing to such a magnificent cause.
You opened up when you had me in your hands, slipping far away with the world at your command. You sing me to sleep and then you hit me awake. It's a perfect life.
The Harvey natural disaster is one that took everyone by surprise. One of the largest natural disasters Texas has ever encountered, and it required a response that's unprecedented. And we were so thrilled that a group like Music Cares was available to come in and provide some quick reaction to serious needs that they have. It was really deeply emotional experience for a lot of these folks.
I've never seen an organization be as efficient in helping people get help for addiction or alcohol abuse.
I know I've called 7 or 8 times for different musicians or crew people.
In 98, I had an accident where I almost severed my thumb on my left hand doing some construction.
I had a really hard time accepting the idea that addiction is a disease. I needed help, and somebody pushed a magic button and poof, I'm in treatment.
This big weight had just been lifted, you know. And someday I'm gonna be able to help someone else like that too.
They saved my life. And I'd bleed for them.
Anybody want to go to 95? Got into 90 here. 9,000, we got 90. Anybody want to go to 95? Got into 90 here. 9,000, 95, got into 90 here.
Yeah. They take care of the people who've taken care of us. With their voices and with their songs, the people whose music have inspired us and soothed our broken hearts, whose music we've gotten married to, music that's been with us on our blackest days, stood by us in war and in peace, made us laugh, made us be strong, informed us and loved us. I've seen it, I've been a part of the miracle of music. Thank you, Music Cares.
Okay. All right, I think we might have. We're trying something different with Will Green here, so.
All right, hang on.
I'm gonna get you out of here, Will, on this other one.
I had to miss my pee break on that one. Oh my gosh. That Pedialyte really gets through you quickly. All right, Kyle Weider's got to be happy now.
All right, I think we got you now, Will. Hold on. Don't go. There we go. Can you see him now?
See who?
Can you see him now? How's that? Constantly working on it, man. Look at
us. Oh, look, I got this cool little, like, halo.
You do? Oh, as always, you're an angel. That's by the way, that commercial we just ran is from Music Cares. That explains what they do. We've been trying to air that every week just because it really, I think it sums up. It's such a great video, such a great ad, or however you want to refer to it. Let's see. I just played, right? It's your turn, right, Will?
I think that's right. I've gotten distracted through all this technology.
Hey, man, I like your Stoney LaRue shirt.
Thank you. I would wear a White Babe Bowen one, but Stoney gives me these for free. So
Hey, speaking of that, hold on. This is what you get for being on Wade's World. You get you a hat.
What?
And I'll bring these to you tomorrow for being a guest on Wade's World. And you get you a Wade's World t-shirt, buddy.
Heck yeah.
Nothing but the best.
That's awesome. I can't wait. I need t-shirts, dude. I need all shirts I can get. I'm getting all these texts coming through saying that this is way better.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. We'll see. We'll see when it starts playing. But you click that using original sound, right?
I can't see you because my merch guy that quit is texting me song requests.
That's awesome.
Tyler, quit texting me.
What does he want to hear?
I don't know. Everybody's texting me now because I told everybody not to text me. they want to hear a Chris Knight song. Do you know Chris Knight songs?
Ooh, I probably know Ain't Easy Being Me, and I could probably pull.
I used to know every Chris Knight song.
Every Chris Knight song?
I used to know every one. I bet I could pull off any one, actually.
I wouldn't mind that. If you want to play a Chris Knight song, I'm always.
What's
up
your
for
favorite
that.
Chris Knight song?
William.
I don't know that one. That one doesn't count because that has my name in it, and I wouldn't play that song anyways.
Oh, you refuse to learn it because it has your name in it?
No, it just sounds a little pretentious, don't you think? If I'm going around playing William, the song William for Chris Knight songs.
I remember William. We're much more than kids. How about Love and a 45?
Yeah, you're doing all the.
You said you know everyone.
You're the worst Chris Knight fan ever. You play the most popular. You want the most popular songs.
Oh my God, are you serious right now?
Yeah,
all
right, I'm dead serious.
Sorry, you don't know those. You're throwing it back at me because you don't know the songs?
Nah, but your requester, you're better than that, Wade.
How about Becky's Bible?
Oh, yeah, definitely know that one. Hit the beer bottle. Ran along my pistol. On the sheet of metal. Song.
I'm proud of you.
Yeah, I told you I knew every Chris Knight song.
Except the first two I asked. Oh, man. So you did what Kyle said, right?
I think. Does it sound like trash?
Man, it sounds great.
You're lying.
No, it sounds great. We're going to do this again, though, when we're in person.
Cool.
I'm going to keep doing these because I like chatting with you. It's fun, man.
Hey, you really want to do some entertaining. Get about 2:30 in the morning on the bus.
Turn it off. crank up the.
You could go on late night with, not late night. What do you call it when you go grub food? I guess it's called late night.
Late night grub? Yeah.
Please.
Randy is Randy's wife Chelsea's always the last few weeks has been cracking me up on our comments. So I don't know if she's been commenting. I think I made Randy mad earlier, so he stopped watching, you said. But other than that, I'm hoping Chelsea's chiming in because she makes me laugh every single week. I want to give a shout out though, Will. I'm sure you want to do the same. I want to give a shout out to all the doctors, nurses, healthcare people out there working so hard to keep us all healthy and keep us. It's not an easy job right now. We have people in our families that are nurses and doctors, and they're doing all they can to keep us healthy. So thank you for all your hard work. And I also want to give a huge shout out to all of the seniors out there. All of the seniors. I can't imagine what you're all going through. I know it's tough. I've been trying to rack my brain. Will, I don't know if you've come up with any ideas, but I'm all ears. We would love any and all ideas of how we can help seniors out there to still enjoy their final year. That's a critical year, obviously, for so many reasons. And, you know, not being able to walk across stage, celebrate all your hard work and all that is tough. I know it's tough. So just thinking about all y'all, I think about you every day, trying to figure out something we can do. I got to play a Zoom concert last night, Will, for some teachers and some for a school in New Braunfels, and it was a lot of fun to see the smiles on their faces. They were dancing in the kitchen and stuff. It was really fun, really beautiful. And you know, as I've said over and over again through this thing, the one thing people have really it may not be considered essential, but music is essential to people, and I've found that out through all of this, that people they want to hear music. They want to hear us still play songs, and they want us to get online and do what we're doing tonight.
Right, but I don't think, you know, getting hammered drunk front row in front of next to 1,000 people is essential.
No, I agree with you.
We'll get there. We'll get back to it.
Will we? I hope so.
I think so. I'm glass half full kind of guy. And if it doesn't, I'm not. I mean, whatever. It's something we can do.
Well, I'm going to do this one here. I haven't played this one. I'm trying to think of songs that I haven't played.
I'm going to go pee in the backyard.
All right. I'm gonna take a pee break.
I'll be back.
Welcome to Wade's World, the ultimate Corn Stream. My guest is William Clark Green this week. And all right. Well, this is one off a record called Solid Ground I had a couple of years ago. This is the second time in three years that the band and crew and I have had to take months and months off. Last time was because of vocal surgery, and now we're here. We are again doing it all. So I guess you could say we have some experience. So, but I still believe in Solid Ground, the record, even though we released it at the beginning of a long break. We can get to work it like we should. Call came in this morning like a thief in the night. It turned dark as hell there in the sun's sweet light. This ain't nothing like I have been told. Held the coffee in my cup's not even cold. It hit me hard, but I ain't felt it yet. It's kind of like a summer storm that you just don't expect. It's crazy how fast a fable heart can lose its hold. Hell, the cigarette I'm holding ain't half smoke. The coffee in my cup's not even cold. Everything is different. Everything has changed. I'm must have been a fool to think that things would stay the same. All events are certain, this old world keeps turning, and you realize that you've been left behind. I don't ever want to hear this song again. You were here when it first began. All the melody forever will remain. Song ain't even sung its last refrain. Hell, the cigarette I'm holding ain't half smoked. The coffee in my cup's not even cold. Everything is different, everything has changed. I must have been a fool, think that things have stayed the same. The only thing that's certain is this old world keeps turning, and you realize that you've been left behind. Well, a call came in this morning like a thief in the night. It turned dark as hell there in the sun, sweet light. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you, Wade. That was awesome.
Let's do another virtual shot, should we?
Go for it. I'm a struggle bus. I'm struggling.
It's cool, man. Literally. I remember my first beer too.
Yeah, a lot more than a beer.
Cheers to everybody out there. Once again, the seniors and healthcare workers and soldiers, all of the moms that are become teachers now. All the teachers out there still keeping our kids going. You got a toast there, Will?
Well, no, I don't.
Yeah, you do. Come on.
I have a joke, but you haven't made the toast yet. I'll say it after the joke.
Okay, we'll do the toast, and then we'll let you tell a few jokes, because that's your favorite thing in the world, I know. Cheers, everybody. Thank y'all. Virtual shots. Thanks for watching Wade's World, episode 9, 9th week. Some of y'all have been here every single week. Truly appreciate it. God bless you.
It's pretty cool that you created this to Woo. Give you an excuse to get drunk at home.
Mm-hmm. My kids are real proud. Shout out to my boys, Bruce and Brock.
Getting big, dude. They're getting huge.
They are, man. They're as tall as me. Can't believe it. What's your joke? Tall. What's your joke? So for those of you that don't know, okay, William Clark Green loves to tell jokes. But not just jokes. You love dad jokes.
Yeah.
Or is it bad jokes?
Bad jokes.
Bad jokes.
This one I think is pretty good, though. All right. How many Vietnam vets does it take to screw in a light bulb?
I don't know.
You don't know? You weren't there.
All right. Give me another one. I know you got a million of them. So Will just randomly calls me all the time, tells me jokes, and then hangs up.
I don't think I have any appropriate ones. I haven't been keeping up with the cheesy ones. I don't have anything. I don't have anything right now. So,
all right, man. Well, you want to play another song for us?
Yeah, I can do that song that you asked me to play.
Please, man. You know, and that was one of the questions someone asked. I can't remember who it was, but someone asked, what's our favorite song of each other's? And this one is my favorite song that you've had. I love this song.
Man, Bruce, it's Bruce Robeson. Man, people keep texting me. It's so annoying. I don't know how to turn it off. I would just turn my Nexus off. Bruce Robeson texted me today about this song, and just out of nowhere, and he said, "Man, it's a great." He told me how much you love the song, and you know that's, and I've gotten to know Bruce the last 2 years, and it's really still to this day to get compliments from him is it's a big deal. I mean,
no, it's a huge deal. Yeah,
so many songs, and he asked me what I was doing. I was like, "Man, I'm in Hangover Hill." And he goes, "God, I wish I was." And I was like, "Really?" He goes, "Dude, I'm so bored." I was like, "Well, you can make it happen."
Yeah, man. I know what you mean about Bruce, man. He's one of the best at the actual craft of songwriting. You know, there's great songwriters, and then there's people who are like him, or just they take the craft so seriously and they really work at it. He's one of the best, man, obviously, ever. He's got a lot of hits and everything, but the ones that aren't hits, to me, are even better. And it's just, the list goes on and on of amazing songs that he's written. And now he's got the next waltz thing that he's doing, which is a fantastic idea, where he's kind of got his own little label thing going, but it's more than that. It's like your own little family thing.
Well, what pisses me off the most about whoever runs his camp as songwriting, they pulled half the stuff offline.
Yeah.
It's bullshit. It's bullshit for me as a fan.
Because of Spotify rules too, right? Or something. I don't know what
the record.
You can't buy the record.
It's something with this publishing or some bull. I mean, it's just bullshit.
Yeah.
Don't even get me started on all that. You've heard my rants, but
yeah,
you know what? I'm a play.
Hey, speaking of rants, do you have rants, or would you, like, I call them man fits. I have man fits where, like, I had one earlier today right in front of both of my kids. The dogs made me mad, and I had a man fit today where you freak out for a good, you know, 2 minutes, and then you come out of it and you wake up and go, "Oh, sorry, everybody." Do you have any of those man fits, or is it just I know your rants.
I like to get drunk and yell, you know.
No, you like to get drunk and argue.
We always do. It's just like, I just try to bait them all night long, reel them in. The cool thing about this song, I'm gonna stop talking. The cool thing about this song is, my favorite memory about this song. I wrote this in Archer City, Texas, with Drew Kennedy, John Bauman, and Josh Grider, and. The cool thing was, on the trip, Bauman was kind of being a little weird, not standoffish, just kind of, his mind did not seem like he was there. And, you know, this was kind of all of our times writing, first time writing together. And so, you know, we just kind of wrote and just kind of, and then finally after we were there for like 3 days, finally after like the second night, Bauman was like, "Guys, I got to get something off my chest." And I was expecting to hear, like, you know, this co-writing thing, it's been a fun trip, but, you know, I got to go. This trip isn't for me, which would be okay. But he was like, I wrote this song and called Gulf Moon, and Kenny Chesney's, I found out today if he's going to cut it or not. And we were like, "What? Like, that's why you're acting like, of course. Like, why are you even here? I would be at home, like, just
popping beers."
And, like, you know, and then once he realized how excited we were for him, and I was like, "Dude, even if he doesn't cut it, like, dude, that's huge. You wrote a song that he's considering putting on a record." Like, and it turns out he gets the call. We're on top of the rooftop of the Spur Hotel there in Archer City. And he gets the call, and we celebrated all night. It was such a cool moment. And then he wrote this song the next day, which was awesome. So,
you know, and it frustrates me for so many reasons, because I love the song, and it's one of those that we have them where you just go, "Man, I wish I'd have written that song. That's a great song." And I was supposed to be on that writing trip. Did you know this? I don't know if you remember or not.
I invite you on writing trips you don't go on.
I know you're going to go there, but that's another thing. But I was supposed to be on that writer's trip, and my voice, that was when I had surgery. And I couldn't go anywhere. I couldn't do anything. I couldn't speak.
How is that recovery on that? Do you still speak in softer tones, or have you noticed any? You know, I had a bad scare for a couple about 3 weeks.
Yeah, I think, you know, it's something would never cross my mind, but it you know, as I've learned, went through all of it, I've learned that it's probably part of our jobs. It's probably just going to happen to all of us in some form or fashion. And luckily I had an amazing doctor, man, that really just saved everything. And Dr. Simpson is just, he's out of San Antonio. Now he moved to Alabama, but he's a fantastic surgeon and really just literally saved my career.
Well, the best part, the good thing that came out of your surgery is now if someone else goes through it, you can help guide them through this experience, which is, I'm sure the unknowing was half the scariness of that, you know?
Oh yeah. Yeah. So. And I've, you know, gotten a lot of phone calls from people that have experiencing vocal problems or, you know, about to have surgeries or whatever it may be. And, you know, I know every level of it, from the scared to how to, you know, get over it. And mentally, when you come back, how scary that is, you know, you come back on stage, you're not sure if your voice is going to work or not. It's pretty crazy stuff. It was the craziest thing I've ever been through, maybe until this. Now, I think this one might, the Corin stream and the pandemic that we're in right now is pretty crazy, I would say, just because it involves everybody.
Well, last night doesn't count, but I, man, just taking some time off from singing three nights a week, my voice, like I said, last night I didn't do my voice any favors, but man, I feel like I feel like a 22-year-old kid that's singing now.
Yeah, you don't come home from the road like, we call it zombie Wade. That's, you know, like, I feel like a zombie Sunday, yeah. Monday recovery from the road, you know, and the voice takes a toll too. And that's what he said. A lot of people in their 40s, you know, I'm in my 40s now, unfortunately. And he was like, you know, that's when a lot of singers come in, start having problems, and they've been going strong for, at that point, I've been going strong for almost 20 years and had never canceled a show ever in my life for having vocal problems. And lo and behold, there it was, 3.5 months of it.
And what I learned when I went is, man, it's just on show days, I just can't talk as much as I want to, you know?
Yeah. And I went through speech therapy too. So they helped me learn how to talk a little bit easier, where I take care of my voice a lot better. But yeah, I learned how to warm up better and all those things that I didn't really know before. I know how to take better care of my voice than I did.
Yeah, me too. It's just, you know, and now I don't even I just have my routines now that, like, I don't go out to dinners before shows, but and like loud dinners, because I won't have a voice after the show.
Because you don't realize you're talking over everybody, yeah.
And my buddies get mad, and it's part of it. It's like, dude, I can't go out. I can't have you on the bus all day talking. I take my naps, and, you know, it seems like I'm being lazy, but you can't do much without talking. Right. You know what I mean? So you can kind of work out. You got to kind of stay away from people. And but yes, it's scary stuff. But and smoking cigarettes is the dumbest thing, which I've done for, you know, 8 years. So I've kicked it. Last night I didn't kick it, but I've kicked the habit pretty good. So, but anyways, I'm quit talking. I'm going to play a song. So this song's called Me, You, and Her, or Me, Her, and You, or something like that. It's one of the two.
Me, Myself, First, and Irene. Me.
Say what?
Me, Myself, and Irene. Yeah. Movie?
So, oh yeah, I'll see that movie. Yeah. Hope this is the right key. First thing in the morning, I wake up next to her, and I think you. Staring down the barrel of another day, and things that I can't. Can't hold the hand I wanna hold, kiss the lips I wanna kiss. I'm craving every inch of you like a cigarette.
First thing in the morning, wake up next to her. I can't fight this awful feeling. Yeah, I feel it all the time. I'm staring at the ceiling, 'cause I can't look her in the eye. And I know that she loves me, and I wanna love her too. I don't know what the hell to do about me, her. You ain't coming back, and I'm not moving on. She ain't got a clue what's going on. What the hell is wrong with me? You goddamn hurt memory holds me like a prison, haunts me like a ghost. I can't stop this awful feeling. Yeah, I feel it all the time. I'm staring at the ceiling, 'cause I can't look her in the eye. And I wanna love her too. I don't know what the hell to do about me, her, and you.
Beautiful, man. Gotta love that song.
It ain't hard when you're out with those guys.
Yeah, but you got the WCG love on that one, man. That's a good song, buddy.
Thank you. The favorite. I've never had a write like it ever before, and no one talked. That song kind of hit everybody. You know what I mean? And everyone was just kind of quiet, because everyone knew what the next line wanted to be. They just wanted to think about it. It wasn't like a laughing fun. Everyone was like quiet. We all sat around this big table, and we all just, I mean, like Drew Kennedy, like he's a critical thinker, right? He's a very brilliant, he's a brilliant man, brilliant mind. That's not me. and to watch the way he works. I mean, but we all worked like Drew Kennedy on that song. You know what I mean? We all wanted to bring our best lines forward because we knew how simple and how important. The song's very simple. Just we all knew the next lines needed to be important. And it was a really fun write.
When you have a moment like that, when you know those moments don't happen every time you write. Unfortunately, I wish they did, but they just don't. And you, everyone in the room can feel when that moment is happening, when you know, holy moly, we're onto a song. This one's different than the others. And it's really cool to have those moments, and you just try to embrace them and just enjoy it while you can. And you get into the moment because they don't, you know, you could write every day, 365 days a year, but those moments like that, they're rare. They really are rare. And that's why you got to take your time with them. And I know that's probably why the room was quiet. 'Cause you just, it's a serious song, and you got to be serious. And man, it's well crafted, really, really well done. Great melody. I just love it. Thank you for singing it.
Yeah, you're welcome. My favorite line in that song, Josh Grider wrote, and it says, holds me like a prison, haunts me like a ghost, and it doesn't rhyme. And when he said that line, we all just went, that's good. Like, you know, yeah. It's just. And I got taken to school because, you know, I wouldn't have never tried not rhyming that line. You know, I never would have tried it. And
Grider's great. I
would have been brave enough to do it in the first place, you know.
Yeah, he's great. He's a great writer, man. So it's, yeah. that's a great room. I hate that I missed that trip. I'm not only good writers, but man, that's a good group of people too. So let's do that trip again, and let me be y'all's fifth wheel.
Dude, come on! I've been trying to get them to do. I had so much fun on that trip. I want to do it again. I think that they think I had too much fun on that trip, and they don't want to do it again.
I've been there. I understand what you're talking about. Hey, Melissa Lawson wants to know, Wade, please ask Will, why is he single? He's a whole package. I love dad bad jokes. Why are you single, Will?
I'm recently single, so that's why.
Someone wants to know what your hat says.
Bill Grease Kettle Company is the name of my kettle company.
I need one of those hats.
I'm actually trying to get Chelsea to sell these at her store. I think they would sell. What do you think?
You know, maybe Tractor Supplies. I'm not sure that her pretty
store
is. Well, they
would be a lot cleaner than this one.
Yeah, but I mean, it's a cattle. It's a cattle company. I'm not sure that River Rose is a. It's a pretty store. Pretty women.
Yeah,
pretty close.
There's nothing in that store to buy for girls that spend money and buy for their husbands.
That's true. True. Good call. She won't do it. I bet she'll do it.
No, she'd do it. I just hadn't sent her any.
Hey, here's a good question from Michael Lopez. He wants to know, when we write songs, how do you decide who gets to put the song on the album?
For me, I never care if someone wants to record the song too.
Yeah, I'm the same way.
Some guys are weird or just like, hey, this is mine, whatever this. Man, I think like when you and Randy did that same song, that was awesome to have two different versions. It was cool to have two different takes of it.
That's what they did back in the day too. Like, you know, Willie Nelson and Willie and Waylon, Good Hearted Woman, and then all of a sudden, you know, Charlie Pride has a hit with it too. You know, it just I love hearing different versions of the same song.
I know. And I think when you box in, man, every time it happens, every time you box in or label something, music, it takes away the validity of it. You know? It's like, why not record it? Like,
yeah,
you know, like all that holding songs, that's a bunch of bullshit. That's my opinion on that. So.
I agree. I like just throwing them out there. If people want to cut them, they should.
Exactly. And it takes
something to make
now,
a record, you know, have a song.
It would be different if I wrote a song and someone who did not write it wanted to cut it. I would probably say no if I was going to cut it. If someone who didn't write it wanted to cut it, they can kiss my ass.
I like that. Yes, we're still doing the weekly Wade's World guitar giveaway, signed guitar. Hey, Will, I'll tell you this. How about we'll try to track down a Wade's World guitar and get Will to sign it tomorrow. So you'll get an autograph. If you buy anything on William Clark Green's merch store online or Wade Bowen's merch store, wadebowen.com, or what is your website, williamclarkgreen.com?
Yes.
williamclarkgreen.com.
I don't know how to use a computer.
Yeah, maybe. Search William Clark Green store. How about that? Or wadebowen.com. If you buy anything on there, you get entered. And if you donate or tip anything, you get entered to win a autographed Wade's World guitar, and we'll get Will Green to sign it along with me. And we're just trying to give away some stuff, Will, and have fun with people and give them something for their dedication to the show.
That's awesome.
Let's see here.
So you have an actual Wade's World guitar. Wade's World. Can you say that five times?
Wade's World guitar. Yes, I have one. We have hats, bandanas, t-shirt. We got it all, baby.
Damn. I'm gonna get set up tomorrow.
We gotta stay alive out here. You know, we gotta. We're trying to get people to go to the merch store, man. That's really the best way to support these artists right now. So.
This
William Clark Green Pedialyte. He loved that too. You could donate Pedialyte to William Clark Green.
It's actually working pretty well. I feel tons better.
You look good. You look better.
Got a little bit more oomph in my step.
I mean, I want to say, man, you've had a lot of requests tonight. It's really cool.
Awesome.
A lot of people asking for a lot of songs. So thank you all very much for for caring. Thanks for tuning in. I know everybody loves William Clark Green as much as I do, so thanks for tuning in, man. Okay.
Thank you for having me.
I'm going to do this one. If I can remember it. Maybe I can't. I might do it now because I can't remember this one. Yeah, I'm going to do West Texas, and I can't remember that one. I was trying to do My California, but I can't remember that. Thanks for the request. I'll do it next week. This is William Clark Green's request on Wade's World, the Ultimate Corn Stream. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. We got a little bit longer, and we'll maybe ask Will to do one more before we get out of here. But thank you very much for tuning in, and we got a few more things up our sleeve, so hang around. This one's called West Texas Rain. Been restless, I have been reckless, I've been a strain on my mom's heart, I've been a drunk, I've been a dreamer, pulling the strings on this old guitar, found a few answers, I still got questions, kept it together and falling apart. And I got cigarettes and stories, old shoebox memories, choices that I'd like to change. Teardrops and laughter, me chasing after, years ago quick as they came, like West Texas rain. Like West Texas rain. Well, I've been a lover. You like that? I've been a father. I've been a brother, and I've been a son. I've been a preacher. I've been a sinner. Yeah, if you can name it, I've probably been one. Strong for the struggle, constantly reaching, reaching for something that I've never done. And I got secrets and stories, old shoebox memories, choices that I'd like to change. Got teardrops and laughter, me chasing after, years ago quick as they came. Like West Texas rain. Like West Texas rain. Like West Texas rain. Just like West Texas rain. Just like West Texas rain. just like West Texas rain.
When you wrote that song, did you know immediately how good it was?
I knew that I was going to enjoy singing it. You know, I wasn't real sure the impact that it would have, but
no one can ever judge that. But I know like there's certain songs, like when I write a song, if I love it so much, I always say, I don't care if no one likes this song. This song's going on the record. You know what I mean? Like, that's kind of like,
that's the way it was with that one.
When I know that I wrote a song that I'm proud of, that's typically what I say is I don't care if no one likes the song record. It's still on record.
Yeah, that's the way I felt with that one, for sure. I mean, I wrote that with Travis Meadows, who's awesome, awesome.
Did
writer.
You really?
Yeah, and you know, it's same with, like, as we were talking earlier. Once when you're in the moment and you're both really onto something, that, you know, it feels like, I hate to say hit, but it feels like a hit. You know, like where it's just like where you know it's going to be a big part of your career.
This sounds super offensive, but I would love to hear his version of that song.
Oh yeah, I got a demo, like a little work tape of it somewhere. I'll go dig it up if I can.
So I wrote with him. If you're not familiar with Travis Meadows, his Killing Uncle Buzzy record is phenomenal.
Amazing. Amazing.
There's a song called Minefield. It'll blow your mind.
it'll fill your mind.
But I wrote with him, and honestly, I was just so interested about his life because he's lived this crazy life. And I just, getting to know him was just so fun.
He's been through a lot. He's been through a lot. And he's better than ever now, which is so cool. You know, I mean, it's like.
He's been alcoholic, drug addict. He's been a preacher. He's been a cardi. He's done everything.
Yeah.
And, his stuff is so, so, so good. But check it out if you get a chance to, y'all. It's great. Killing Uncle Buzzy record. My top three, honestly, my record that I recommend right now, which you're not asking for, but I'm going to give it anyways. The Patty Griffin 1,000 Kisses record is phenomenal. Patty Griffin 1,000 Kisses. That Travis Meadows record's great. And
what just happened?
God dang it. Someone's calling me. I'm taking FaceTime.
You're good. Hey, that's the beauty of live TV, buddy.
Now they're doing it on purpose.
Yeah.
So,
well, you said 1,000 Kisses.
1,000 Kisses, Patty Griffin, and I mean, I just don't even know. We're gonna have to stop. Just this guy won't quit calling me.
1,000 Kisses. What's the other two?
Killing Uncle Buzzy by Travis Meadows.
And. They can still hear you. It's all right. What's your third one?
And the third one is, I don't know. I'm so mad at this guy right now. the Norah Jones Telltale record is great.
Yes, yes.
Absolutely great. Absolutely great.
Good record.
And Vince Gill's first record, that Red album, I forgot the name of it. That was great. I mean, there's just a lot of those. That Patty Griffin record is one of my favorite females. I've got my top three females, that Norah Jones, Patty, and then Laura McKenna, her record before this last one. Not their last one wasn't great, but
Burn Lorraine
is great.
I love Lorraine. That was my favorite Laura McKenna record. Lorraine, yeah. And the Patty Griffin 1,000 Kisses record is like literally. I guess it's in my top three because that changes quite a bit, but it's always in my top three favorite records of all time.
Yeah,
love it.
It's a great record, man. And she is such a powerful singer. I learned Dadgad from her.
Oh, yeah.
She's
a phenomenal singer. Great writer.
Not from her, but just from mimicking her. Yeah, mimicking her.
Laura McKenna was on the show last week and made everybody cry and see how amazing she was. She was, you know, she sang one song for us, and it was amazing. Hey, well, okay, so here's the deal. For your round, since it's a song swap, right, I picked out a track from your Live from Cheatham Street album that I'd like to play. maybe you could talk a little bit about. I know your appreciation for Kent Finley. I was pretty close to Kent, but not anything like you and Randy were. And I loved Kent. He was a tremendous, amazing human being. Loved being around him every second I was ever around him. And so we chose the Chili song. We pulled the video with Charlie Stout, and we're gonna play it. But I would just like you to intro it and talk about Kent, you know.
Well, we do an 806 songwriting retreat every year that you're invited to that never shows up to.
Continue. Go on. Go on.
And did you like how I set that up?
Yeah. You like threw that in there. Slid that in there.
So me and Charlie Stout got, we draw straws pretty much to see who's going to write with each other. And me and Charlie Stout got on one. And we were trying to write. You know, I'd have an idea. He'd think it sucked. He had an idea I wasn't really interested in. He said, we need to write a song. He goes, the song idea I had, he thought was complete garbage. He goes, Will, we need to write a song that Kent would be proud of. And that's pretty much his way of saying, you suck. Your ideas suck. We're not doing that, you know? And so I was like, well, let's just write a song about for Kent. And he was like, I can do that. I was like, we both love him. That's where, our, you know, and so, you know, Kent, Charlie has a lot of passion for Kent and Chim Street, and really videography a lot of his video a lot of his, you know, his last years on this planet, which is so awesome that he did that. I mean, looking back now, we just, like, you know, what's the one thing Kent loved the most? Is Chim Street and his family in Chile. And so we were like, and we just started doing it, and we were laughing our asses off. It's so much fun about the song. And I didn't think it was going to be that. I didn't think I was going to make a record. I didn't know when I wrote it. And then as soon as we got done with it, I started making Chili, and we're just having so much fun with it. Everybody was kind of singing along on the retreat to it. And I was like, this is going to be a song. Like, I can't believe this is going to be a song. This is great.
That's awesome, man.
It's really cool.
Yeah. Yeah. It's fun. And you had your live at Green Hall, and then you followed it up pretty quickly with the live from Cheatham Street. Like, you just liked the moment. I mean, what, you know, you just liked the live stuff.
I wanted to have the live at Cheatham Street was my dream band back in college. That's exactly what I wanted to do. Broke down acoustic sit down set stuff. The rock and roll thing didn't really happen until I met Jay, my drummer, that you stole from me.
He's a good drummer.
Man, I'm coming out strong tonight.
What do you mean tonight? You mean every night.
Yeah. And Jay taught me how to be a rock and roll. Everything I wrote was train beat back in the day. And Jay encouraged me not to do that and turned my songs into rocking songs. And that's how we turned into a rock band because of that. I mean, honestly, I want to be a folk, you know, snare drum brushes band. That's what I wanted to do. Mm-hmm. And Jay kind of changed that. And I ended up having a lot of fun doing that on stage with rock and roll. And pretty much learned from you. I mean, you've always had awesome guitar players and a really loud rocking band. And that's kind of what we emulated too. I just wanted to do a live record different. And I want to do all the songs in my catalog that wasn't on that previous record. So I want to do deeper cut stuff.
And you did there's how many songs on the, I mean, there's a lot of songs on there. How many songs are on the record?
18 or 19. It's a full show.
It's a great record. I know Kyle Hutton, his company, right?
Yeah, they filmed it. And then my buddy,
Real
Mills
Content
Logan,
Solutions.
They're great. And
great company.
Yeah, great guys to work with. Super affordable too. And the Mills, my buddy, tracked it. And man, I'm just so proud. That's honest to God, Wade. That's my most proud record. And has nothing to do with being Cheatham Street and how much that has nothing to do with that. The guys absolutely killed it. We had one show. There wasn't two. We didn't repeat any songs. I mean, it's a real, I didn't read the vocals. It is 100% real, you know?
Yeah.
And the guys just showed up and played phenomenally well. And I'm very
proud. Your band
of
is great. Your band is a great band. And having those added guys on there too is really cool. Yeah. I know. It's fun to have those special nights when you have the dream band. You know, they're few and far between. As much as we tour, we don't get to have the luxury of taking off for 3 months and then doing a tour and then coming back and taking off and doing a tour. And we're always on tour, so it's hard to constantly have those guys, but when you have those special nights like this, man, I love it. I love the record. I love the feel of it, and I'm glad that you captured one of those nights and had a great band behind you. And this is from it. This is a clip we stole.
I feel like it's edited. I feel like you did some. I feel like there's a
no.
Drawn in my forehead or something.
No, I wish that would have been smart if I'd have done that. But this is I just want to show this. You know, the Wade's World is all about the guests. It's all about talking about them and asking their thoughts on music and the world and everything else. So we try really hard to cover everything we can. I really want y'all to hear this. This is a really fun, entertaining song, and it really captures the energy that was there that night at Cheatham Street. This is William Clark Green and his band live from Cheatham Street, the Chili Song.
So I was talking about our 806 song. We're going to do this song as many times as it takes to get it done right, because this song is the entire reason we did this record. So I really don't, if you guys want to, this might take a while. Hopefully we'll nail it the first time, but we're going to do it as many times as it takes. We do this Lubbock songwriting retreat, and there's a lot of special songs that come out of the songwriting retreat. And me and Charlie Stout were at the bar there at Larry Joe's place, and we were writing this song, and the song sucked, and it was awful, and we both were just having a miserable time because I thought it sucked, but I didn't want him to know that I thought it sucked, and he thought it sucked, but he didn't want me to know that it sucked. And finally, I was like, this sucks. And he was like, I totally agree, this sucks. And so we started talking about songwriting. And, of course, we talked a lot about Kent. And come on over here, Charlie.
Whose chair do I steal?
Can you stand up and play? Take his chair.
Yes, I
can. And so we're sitting there, and like I said, Charlie was with Kent a lot in his last years, and so we got to start about Kent, and I was like, we need to write a song that Kent would love. And I said, what does Kent love? And Charlie goes, well, Kent loved chili. And Kent was a huge advocate. He'd always say, if you put beans in your chili, you don't know beans about making chili. And this is my protest song. This is as political as I will ever get on stage. And that is my promise to you. And like I said, we're going to do this song as many times as it takes. Because the words are really complicated for me.
Oh, yeah.
But we're going to try. So we'll see what happens. Let me make sure I'm in tune real quick. This song is called Don't Put No Beans in My Chili.
Cheers, my friend.
If anybody wants to argue with you about beans belonging in chili, it's like, it's okay. Now, I like chili beans. Chili beans is great. There's nothing wrong with chili beans. But it's not possible to have chili with beans in it. It's like, it can't exist. Like, it doesn't. If it has beans in it, it's not called chili. It's called chili beans. I like chili beans.
What you've made, Kent used to say, you haven't made chili. You've made stew. Kent would fight you about this.
Oh, no, he was very serious about his chili.
No, I've never seen him throw people out of the bar.
So his son Sterling is here, and everything. Was it, where's Sterling at tonight? Raise your hand if you're...
If you're Sterling, raise your hand.
Oh, hey, Sterling. Oh, there's a poll. But was it Thanksgiving or Christmas? Y'all would do chili cook-off every Christmas, Thanksgiving? And y'all still do? I would love to be invited to that someday. I'd bring a shitload of beans. So this is called the chili song. So let's see what happens here. Get that fire hot, and you get you a big old pot. Fill it up with a little bit of water and a bottle of beer.
chili powder, onion, garlic, and a made of ground beef, black pepper, and a green jalapeno, a little bit of cumin, and one more bottle of beer. But don't you put no beans in my chili. Don't you put no beans in my chili. If you put beans into my chili, you don't know beans about making chili. It's meant to be fun, folks. Well, you bring it to a simmer, grab a wooden spoon, take a little taste, see what you gotta do. If it ain't just right just yet, buddy, have no fear. And you can add a pinch of salt if it feels a little light, cayenne pepper if it needs more bite. If it seems too thick, add one more bottle of beer. Don't you put no beans in my chili. Don't you put no beans in my chili. If you put beans into my chili, you don't know beans about making chili. Now you can eat it with a spoon or a stack of saltines. Add in some bacon bits, a little shredded cheese, a splash of Tabasco, a dash of sour cream. But it ain't Texas chili if you make it with beans. Don't put no beans in my chili. Don't you put no beans in my chili. If you put beans into my chili, you don't know beans about making chili. Don't put no beans in my chili. Don't put no beans in my chili. If you put beans into my chili, you don't know beans about making Texas chili.
That's William Clark Green, live from Cheatham Street with an amazing band. His band, but a few additional guys. And
yeah.
What a fun record, man. What a fun song. And what a fun time, man. I'm happy for you. You know, there's a lot of people that, you know, I don't know. You know, the live record used to be such a thing. And it's
the CD sales. I mean, you wanted to sell CDs at shows, you know.
And yeah, and live albums were so popular. You know, I mean, we had the, back in 2002, we recorded Blue Light Live, for crying out loud.
A great record.
You know? And then we had all the Billy Bob's Live, Billy Bob series that they've done over and over again. It's like, you know, I'm not sure people still dig the live stuff or not, but when you see the reaction, the response that you've gotten from your Live at Green and Live at Cheetah, man, it's been pretty awesome.
Saying, man, people love seeing the people. Like, there's a lot of people who don't get to go to shows, you know, especially you got kids, two or three kids on the ground, and they just, you know, they're working their asses off trying to prevent them from killing themselves, you know. That's what I figure out parenting is. It's just, you just try to prevent the kids from killing themselves all day long.
That's a terrible thing to say.
Well, that's what kids try to kill themselves every day.
Okay, like. let's not talk about that. Let's move on to something else.
Yeah, see, you're looking into it too much. Anyways, where was I going with this?
I don't know. All right, I'll do one more, and then I'll let you send us home. How about that?
Yes.
Is that good?
Before I say anything else.
No, you're good, man. I was just telling you when that video was running, man. We've had so many requests tonight. So many people saying that you're one of their favorites, and that you've been an absolute blast tonight. So thanks for being a trooper, man. I know this is a long show, but you know, people stick around, man. They tune in at 8 and they stick around, and here we are 2.5 hours later and still rocking and still having fun. And we got just as many people as we did when it first started. So,
well, thank y'all very much for listening to me. Wade, throughout all my shit talking, Wade is a great person and a good friend to me. So thank you, Wade. I appreciate you having me on.
Always, man. Always.
Yeah.
And before we get out of here, I want to I'll play this one, and then we'll talk about the Panhandlers, because we've not talked about them enough tonight. So. This is by request. I was glad to see this one come across. I don't get to play this one very much. So. This is a Vince Gill inspired song, Will. This is a Vince Gill inspired song. I'm trying to channel my inner Vince Gill man crush. Just another crowded cafe morning. She sits by the window all alone. God, there's just something about that woman. Pretty as anything I've ever known. Sweet Leona, you are fine wine, you are sunshine, you are rain, sweet Leona. I can't find a word to say. Oh, every time your sweet eyes look my way. Don't know how a girl like her gets lonely. She captures every man with her charm. She could take me as a willing prisoner if the penalty was wrapped up in her arms. Sweet Leona, you are fine wine, you are sunshine, you are rain, sweet Leona. Can't find a word to say. Oh, every time your sweet eyes look my way. Someday I might get the nerve to ask her. Yeah, and someday the owner might say yes. But today I smiled when I walked past her. Oh, and she smiled back at me and took my breath. Oh, Leona. Oh, sweet Leona. Can't find a word to say. Oh, every time your sweet eyes look my way. Yeah, every time your sweet eyes look my way. Oh, every time your sweet eyes look my way. Oh, thank you. Thanks,
that
Will.
Sounds like a La La Lovett song. That's what
I'll take
me
that.
Of.
I'll take that. Yeah.
Every
time awesome. Your sweet eyes look my way.
Man, so I've never seen him live, and my dream gig is I want to open up for him at Bass Hall here in Fort Worth. Just me and my guitar.
Surely you can make that happen. Right?
For him, that's just my dream gig for me.
Surely you can make that happen.
Yeah, Dave, if you're listening.
Hey, before you get out of here, Will, Stacy wants to know, it's a good question because I'm sure a lot of people are thinking this because you played them tonight. I know the answer, but go ahead and give the answer. Are Any More and Me, Her, and You on albums? They want to go look them up.
They want to go look them up. Me, Her, and You is on YouTube under the Next Waltz. And Any More is brand new. So Any More will be on the next album. Probably be our first single off the next album.
There you go, Stacy. There's your answer. So many of y'all, thanks for all these requests. It's So awesome. Matt Overman is the one who asked for Sweet Leona. Thank you very much. Appreciate that. I love Eric asking for a Jack Ingram song. It's pretty awesome. We love Jack.
I love Jack. I've been listening to him my whole life, just about.
So let's before we get out of here, man, you know, I went on a jog the other day when you guys released the Panhandlers album. I went on a jog.
So you went on a jog once in the last 2.5 months?
Well, it was that day that I went. Yes, I've been on actually twice. But it's like my time to listen to new music. It's like, it's really cool to dive into albums while I'm running, walking. And I love panting. Yeah, dying. But I love, it's a really cool, it takes my mind off because I hate cardio.
Yeah, I ride a bicycle, and I hate that I do it, but it's the easiest workout. And it's fun, it's kind of fun. But
you've been doing that a lot. Yeah, you've been doing that a lot.
I hate that I do it.
But I listened to the Panhandlers record, man, and it's great. It's really great. I loved it. The songs are cool. They're very West Texas, but it's also Bruce Robinson produced it. Is that right? With the Next Waltz?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
It has that analog feel, that sound to it. Real authentic and vintage almost at times. And
yeah,
really cool, man. I love the songs. You got Cleto from Flatland. You got Joe Dahman, Josh Abbott. And then you are the four that make up the Panhandlers. You have a record. I'm assuming you were touring it or getting ready to tour.
We had just done our first show at Steamboat. We were literally planning on doing some more shows, but it just all.
Yeah, with all that's going on.
It'll hit stop. So, but you know, it's just like with everything else, man. It's just one more thing to add on the list when we get back going. We're gonna be busy. So,
yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's a cool project, and I know it's when you get, you know, I know with Randy and I, when we get together and do a Hold My Beer thing, it's like, it's so much fun because we're buddies, and you just kind of forget about, not that this is work anyway, this isn't work. This is the coolest job in the universe, getting to play music for people, but it really takes it to another level of fun, and I can't imagine four of us together touring around would be really fun.
So there's so many, and I don't know if the guys have the same feelings about this as I do, but what I noticed is that no one wanted to step on anybody's toes, and there was no real leader, and everything has to have someone that does something. And so it's just kind of, everyone was too afraid to speak up about certain stuff. And so I feel like that was something we learned. We got everyone's roles kind of got established still, but it was a learning process. And plus, we had no idea what we were doing. I mean, we're supposed to be a cover record, you know, and it just evolved and evolved and evolved. And we wrote some songs, and the songs were kind of good and pretty good. And I was like, man, we should just do all of them, you know, all the songs. So original songs. And so it's just kind of been everyone's kind of on the outside. We hadn't like jumped in. I mean, I guess we've jumped in now, but the whole process of writing it, I mean, everyone was just kind of scared to piss somebody else off. So I think the more that we get comfortable with that, I think you'll see some really cool things start happening with that group too. Not that they haven't already started. I'm just saying we were kind of timid in the studio.
Yeah, you get more comfortable with
Bruce
it.
Bruce is intimidating to be around because he's a brilliant man. And but yeah.
Yeah, man. Well, it's really great stuff. Check it out. Check out all the William Cart Green stuff. You're a great writer, dude. You're a great singer, great band. Love everything you do, and I just look forward to sharing the stage with you tomorrow. As always, it's always fun.
I'm literally, you're gonna get so sick of me. I guess you can't say what we call it, stage joining.
stage joining
you tomorrow.
I hope, man. At least West Texas Rain, if not every song, but it's gonna be good to get back on stage with you, man. It's gonna be good to get back on stage with the bands and. There's probably not going to be a ton of hanging out like normal. We'll do our social distancing the best we can. But thanks again for the 9th episode, Wade's World, Ultimate Corn Stream. So thankful that you tuned in. thanks for the tips. Thanks for the donations. Thanks for Music Cares and the money that we can give to them. Thanks for donating money to Will and his band and family that we're all struggling, and you've helped us out a ton. Thanks for buying our merch. Thanks for buying Will's merch. Thanks for supporting the artist in this craziness. And I'm going to let, as in typical Wade's World fashion, I love the artist starting it off, and I love the artist, the guest taking us home, man. So send us home with a beautiful song, man. Thanks again.
Well, thank you, Wade, for being a good friend. I look forward to seeing you in 10 hours. This song by request. I wrote the song with Brad Tersey, who is the, before this happened, he has just started a band called Old Dominion. And he was asking me questions about touring and what we do. And when this song came out a year and a half later, Old Dominion was on the way of blowing up, and this song went number one first. And he sent me a text message. He said, you'll always be number one, my number one, my first number one. And I was like, that was pretty cool. And then he's got like, 500 of them. So this song's called Sympathy. This guy also wrote Flash Flood, but Randy Rogers, Trouble Records. I know how you feel.
Awesome, dude. Thank you so much, William Clark Green, everybody. Hey, William, we're going to get you together with us on another Wade's World down the road when there's no virtualness. We're going to get together and hang out and play enjoy the fellowship.
I would love to come down there and hang out and be brought up with you, buddy. So.
Someone said, how do you buy anything on the internet?
I don't blame them. Valid question. When you find out, let me know.
Hey, Hey, always love hearing you, man. Always love hanging out with you. And thank you again for being a part of Wade's World. Thank you again for helping us raise money for Music Cares. And thank you again to everybody that donated for helping William Clark Green get down the road and give money to his band and crew, and just supporting what we love to do with our lives. We truly love music. We love coming into your living rooms every, or whatever it is, wherever you're listening. We love hanging out. We forgot one of these. Wreck 'em, Guns Up, Red Raiders.
I still don't know the words to the fight song.
Me either. We just, fight, fight, fight. Hey, anyway, man, thank you so much. I love your shiny shirt. Fight, fight, fight. All right. Love you guys. Thanks again. Wade's World will be back next week, I believe, with Aaron Watson. Then the week after that will be Josh Abbott. And then I believe Jamie Lynn Wilson will be there. So we're going to keep doing this. We love you guys, and we're going to keep trying to bring the music to you. And thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next week. Here's, as always, we end with our PSA montage of all of our buddies. Take care. Stay safe. Take care of each other. Take care of yourself. And as always, we love you. Call your mom.
See you down.
Hey y'all, Cody here with the Reckless Kelly Band. Just wanted to say hi and sing a little song I wrote called We Will All Get Through This Together. It goes like this. We will all get through this together if we all do our part. Don't cough, sneeze, or fart on each other unless it's your brother. Yeah, we will all get through this together. Love y'all. Be good. Take care of each other. Bye.
That's about 6 feet, isn't it?
Yeah, that's about 6 feet.
Okay.
Hey, guys. Willie Braun.
Gary Braun.
We're out at the dump looking for things to wipe our butts with. It's going pretty good so far. I found a half a thing of baby wipes.
Yeah, and we also wanted to remind everybody to keep at least 6 feet difference.
About
or
six
distance.
Feet.
Distance.
Yeah.
It's important right now.
And don't go coughing on each other or nothing.
Yep. And we hope that the toilet paper shortage is treating you better than it's treating us.
Oh. Hey, right behind you.
Oh, nice.
Newspaper, that'll work.
The failing New York Times.
Yeah. Anyway, be safe, everybody.
Hey, y'all. Be safe, be kind, and we'll get through this together.
It's okay, y'all. It's okay. Don't panic. It's going to be fine. I love y'all. Music kills. Be safe. Yeah, okay.
Hey, guys. I know these are pretty weird times right now, but we're going to stick together. And we're going to stay safe, and we're going to stay strong. And remember, music is healing.
Hey, everybody. We just wanted to wish you well and let you know we're thinking about you during this crazy, unprecedented time. We're enjoying spending time with each other, which we never really get to do, and hanging out with our friends and family that we never get to see. And we can't wait to be back out on the road and making more music for you guys and playing songs for you, so hope to
and
see
drinking
you.
A beer with you too.
Yeah, drinking a beer and having a good time, and hope to see you down the road doing all those things. In the meantime, hope you're staying safe, staying indoors, and
growing out your beards.
Playing a little t-ball out here in the backyard today with Hattie because baseball season has been postponed for a while. Anyway, I hope everyone's having a good day, and it's beautiful out here in the backyard. I even put on my Wade Bowen throwback shirt. I hope you guys are good, and we'll see you on down the old dusty trail.
Hey, everybody. Remember, music heals. Be safe, be kind, be good to each other. See you soon from the Randy Rogers Band.
Hey, music heals. We'll get through this together. Y'all be safe, be kind.
Hey y'all, music heals. Be safe, be kind to each other, and we'll all get through this together.
Ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, hope everybody's doing well. Be kind to one another, it's a trying time. Let's get through this together, and we'll be out there as soon as we can playing for you guys again. Peace.
Hey friends, I just wanted to remind y'all that this new way of life is only temporary. We're gonna get through it together, be safe, be kind to one another, and remember that music heals.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's Coe Wetzel.
I just wanted to tell y'all to be safe out there and take care of one another, man. World's in a crazy spot right now, and we all need each other, man. We're going to get through this. So y'all take care, and we'll see y'all soon.
Hey, everybody. Pat Green here. You know what music heals?